5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। सर आई एम अफ्रेड, आई एम नॉट इन अ पोजिशन टू सपोर्ट द रेजोल्यूशन विच हैज बीन मूव्ड बाई माई फ्रेंड। आई एम नॉट अपोजिंग दिस रेजोल्यूशन बिकॉज आई एम अनमाइंडफुल ऑफ द लार्ज नंबर ऑफ अब्यूजेस दैट एग्जिस्ट इन द कॉरपोरेट सेक्टर, और आई एम लेस एंथुसियास्टिक माईसेल्फ इन सीइंग दैट दीज अब्यूजेस शुड बी रिमूव्ड एज अर्ली एज पॉसिबल, बट द मेथड दैट ही हैज सजेस्टेड इज सो डायलेटरी एंड द प्रॉब्लम बिफोर अस इज सो एक्यूट दैट नो यूजफुल पर्पज विल बी सर्व्ड बाई अपॉइंटिंग वन मोर कमीशन टू इन्वेस्टिगेट इन टू द वर्किंग ऑफ द कॉरपोरेट सेक्टर when we have got enough data, and to my mind we have already got enough statutory powers to see that these abuses are checked and if possible completely eliminated. I do not see what this commission can do, whether it can throw more light on the malpractices that are rampant in the corporate sector. We all know that any commission that deals with the particular problems of a particular industrial concern gives ample evidence of the fact that malpractices exist in the corporate sector and the government is aware of it. I watch one of the members of the Joint Select Committee on the Company Law Amendment Bill 1998, which ultimately became the Company Law Amendment Act 2000, and in that committee also enough evidence was brought forward to show that malpractices existed in the corporate sector, and certain salutary amendments in the company law were made. In spite of these amendments and in spite of the original Companies Act, we do find that abuses still persist, and the question before us is how to deal with the abuses rather than investigate further into the nature of the abuses and the extent of the abuses. To my mind, the real remedy for us is not that of appointing commissions and committees and thereby postpone the solution of an urgent problem, but to deal with the problem here and now with the agency which is at our disposal. This agency is the Department of Company Law Administration, which is working under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry of the Government of India. This agency has again and again, year after year, in its reports complained that they have not got enough personnel to deal with the large responsibilities that have been placed on them. It is this lacuna in our administrative machinery, it is this weakness in the agency which is called upon to see that the company law becomes a fit instrument for checking and eliminating the defects in the working of the corporate sector, which is mainly responsible for the persistence of abuses. The real solution of the problem before us is to strengthen the administration, to enlarge its power, to enlarge its scope of inquiry, and above all, for the government to take prompt and effective measures against abuses which have been pointed out by the company law administration. Mere incorporation of the abuses in the report is not enough. It is necessary for the government to act, and I would be happy to know what action the government has so far taken against the specific abuses that have been pointed out in the report. If these abuses to which the attention of the government is drawn in the report remain unpunished or had not received the attention of the government to the extent it deserves, there is likelihood of the impression gathering in the public mind that the government is not serious in enforcing this law and root out evils which this law is called upon to root out. It is in this connection that we have painfully to draw your attention again and again to the possible connections that might exist between large units in the corporate sector on the one hand and the government machinery on the other. There is an impression in the public mind that influence in right quarters is an absolute minimum necessary in order to get things done, and it is this which is responsible for the concentration of economic power in the corporate sector. The other day, the Prime Minister made a statement in the other house dealing with this problem and pointed out that an elaborate machinery exists to deal with the problem of licensing, that it is the policy of the government that licenses are only given according to the merits and the needs of the situation, and that when there are no compelling reasons, there is always preference given to new entrants and new entrepreneurs. Though the company law exists, though it incorporates certain very salutary provisions, though an enforcement machinery exists, and though the machinery has tried its level best, I must say, to administer the law as it is, because of administrative difficulties, because of political considerations to which the government has not given its full attention, the purpose for which the act was passed by Parliament and the money is voted by Parliament, is not fulfilled.